Years ago, they skated to the music of Franz Liszt. It was called The Dream of Love. They were scheduled to skate to the music of Tchaikovsky's Swan Lake now. But Artur Dmitriev said, we need something to set us apart, something more dramatic. Thus, they have chosen the music of Rachmaninoff.
Graphically, this program is still loaded with a lot of very difficult content, opening with side-by-side triple toe loops. Beautiful throw, triple toe loop.
That was breathtaking.
Natalia said her reason for coming back and competing in the Olympics again was, she said, in Albertville, I wasn't perfect. Tonight, she was.
Iskyu Charnock and Dmitriev trying to defend the gold medal they won in Albertville, and on the ice for the warm-up now. They're good friends, but from a different style of skating. Gordieva and Grinkov, they represent the Moscow school. Mara Mosbina with Natasha.
Take a look at this lift. They're going down the ice full speed. Perfect handhold position, great posture, one hand all the way down the ice. They have so many tools. They have so many things to work with. Her flexibility, his passion, drama, reckless abandon on the ice. The depth of this team is just incredible. What makes a great champion? 2 days ago, we didn't think they were in this thing. Turning in back-to-back, beautiful performances.
And the marks for Iskyu Charnock and Dmitriev for technical merit.
And there's a little bit of room here, 5-6 from the U.S. The 5-8s and 5-7s can be beat by a technically great pair of Gordieva and Grinkov, but Gordieva and Grinkov can't make any mistakes.
And the second set of marks.
Well, looking at the differences between Gordieva and Grinkov and Iskyu Charnock and Dmitriev, it's apples and oranges. It's perfection or passion. And it looks like some of the judges like the passion and others are waiting for the perfection.
Seven of the nine judges have put Iskyu Charnock and Dmitriev over Brasseur and Eisler. But now, the 1988 Olympic gold medalists.